Namaskar. It's my great pleasure to welcome you all to the volume 1 of Listen and Learn Tabla. It's our endeavor to teach tabla through this DVD as a guru would to his disciple. And we sincerely hope it would come as a good tool for you, one and all, who wish to learn tabla through the DVD. Thank you. We begin with the various parts of tabla by introducing the various parts of tabla. As you can see, there are two different drums. The one which is on the right side, this is called tabla or chati. This is made up of wood. It's a log, and the log is cut hollow inside, and we have got the goat skin, which we call as pudi. It is placed on the top of the log, wooden log, and it is tied like this with the tiny skins, goat skin again. This is called gajra. So pudi is tied with the gajra. Then to tighten it on the chati, we use the baddi, or it is called vadi. It is used as a rope to tighten this pudi, which is, as you can see, a hole is pierced on the gajra, and the vadi or baddi, vadi is put through this and it is tightened up at the end. This part is called kundal, where this rope is tightened up. So as such, we can see that the pudi is placed on the wooden log, hollow log, and it is tied with the vadi. Now we have got these wooden parts. These are called gatta. It is used to tighten up the rope, the strings. When we hit is on the direct downwards, there is pressure. We have pressure on the strings, on the ropes, and the pudi gets expanded. In this way, the sound goes up. I'll show you an example. It goes up. When we hit it from the bottom side, from the lower side, the strings gets loosened up, and the pressure on the pudi, the pudi gets loosened up. You can see the difference. First we hit the gatte. If you want to increase the level, the tuning, that is the tone of the pudi, according to the scale on which we are playing. Like for instance, I have tuned this tabla to C sharp. If the tone is little lesser, we strike the gatte from the top side, as I have shown you. When we hit the gatte from downwards, the skin gets loosened, so the pitch gets lower. Now you can see the difference. In the same way, if we hit it from the top, if we hit it downwards, the skin gets tightened and the pitch goes up. while there's a much different is there in the pitch of the tabla and the tanpura. We hit it on the gatte, downwards or upwards, as I had told earlier. And if fine tuning is needed to be done, we just hit it slightly on the gajra. If we want to make the tabla, we want to take it to the higher pitch, we hit it slightly, fine tune on the gajra. We hit it from upward and the pitch goes up. If we want to lower the pitch, that is fine tuning, we hit it from downwards. So automatically the pitch gets lower. This is how tuning is done. So this is the use of gatte, vadi and gajra. Now on the skin, on the pudi, you can see three different parts. This portion on the corner is called chaat or kinar. The next portion on the middle, it is lav or maidan, what we call. Then this black portion, it is called shai. Shai, it is made of lead contents, and it is this portion which creates a resonance, in the tabla. You can feel the sound, you can feel the resonance. This is how a tabla is placed, and it is played with the right hand, chati, tabla or chati. Now this portion, this drum, this is called dagga. It is made of metal like brass, copper, and it is polished. Like this polish, we have got a silver polish. Again, the same way, a pudi is placed on the top of the dagga and it is tightened with the strings of the made by the goat skin. Again, we have got the kundal and it is tied to the kundal. Here the same portions, gajra, and we have got this gatte. It is made up of wood, and nowadays fiber gatte is also coming. This is especially made up of brass one. This gatte is specially made one. It is of brass. So this is dagga and this is tabla or chati. Both these together we call tabla pair, a pair of tabla. And as I have told you, tabla or chati is played with the right hand and dagga is played with the left hand. And we have got this part, it is called the ring. As you can see, it's round in shape. It is just kept down so that while playing, the tabla doesn't move or it is not uncomfortable to play. It acts just like a stand or a support for the tabla. We place the tabla at a degree of 60 or 70 degrees as per the convenience of the tabla player, and the guy is kept straight. This is how it is played. After going through the parts of the tabla, now I will tell you the seating posture. We sit cross leg, and we have to sit in the center of both tabla and dagga, the chati and dagga. We should sit straight, shoulders should be straight and relaxed, but not too stiff or tight. Hand should come from the outer side. As you see, it should take this posture. Fingers, it should be placed like this on the chati and on the dagga like this. The middle finger of right hand is always kept up. It should not come down. It is kept in this angle of 60 or 70 degree or say 80 degrees as per the convenience of the tabla player. This is how dagga is played. Let me play it together. Played in the same fashion. Key is half beat and ta is half beat. Ti ra ti ta. So this bowl we play like this. Dha dha ti ra ti ta. Dha dha ti ra ti ta. Dha dha ti ra ti ta. Now we play on the tabla. Dha dha ti ra ti ta. Dha dha ti ra. Tira kita and theta are played. These two bowls are considered a very important bowl in tabla, as when we move on to our next stage, that is the next level, where we start learning the lessons in different tals, we play some kaidas in which theta is the main bowl. And there are some kaidas where tirakita is used as the main bowl. So we will be learning these kaidas in the latter stage.